So my name's Rick Ray, and I'm a contributor to Adobe Stock and other stock libraries around the world. Basically, I've been traveling for 35 years around the world with small, inconspicuous, low-key video equipment, capturing stock footage that I then resell to clients that need it. And it's become an adventure. I've visited now 70 countries, and I shoot 4K everywhere I go now. I upload to Adobe Stock, and I'm one of the top resellers of footage in the world. This is essentially just some of my work, just looking at some that's recently been shot. You'll see a lot of world footage, a lot of wildlife, and I currently have about 20,000 contemporary clips and 110,000 archival clips online not at Adobe, but at various places. Now, there's a lot of cool gear here at NAB. We've seen it. But this isn't the kind of gear you want to take into a third world country, because you immediately stand out as a professional. You're doing something. The government, police, other authorities may question what you're doing and why you're doing it. So that's why I believe in trying to find gear that really still shoots beautiful footage, that doesn't make you look like you stand out at all. I use the FDR, this little Sony FDR AX100. I carry a drone, but it's the Mavic Pro, so it's the small one that folds and doesn't look very big. I carry a little Osmo, DJI Osmo, for getting glide shots. So I use Adobe Premiere Pro to do all of my color correcting, all of my editing, and there isn't a lot of editing in stock footage. It's a shot by shot by shot sort of export, and each shot has its own life and its own value. So I work very hard in the Lumetri color program. I denoise my clips, and I work on them, sometimes putting them into slow motion, and other effects are added in Premiere Pro. And then when I go to Media Encoder to export the clips, there's a little box, a checkbox now in Media Encoder that allows me to upload them directly to Adobe Stock. At that time, if you have an account already established, Adobe Stock assigns keywords using its Sensei system. So it automatically analyzes what is in the content of the shot, assigns keywords, and you can go in and add more specific ones that you feel are appropriate. And then it goes through curation, make sure that all releases are signed and so on. And at that point, it can go online immediately and start making you money. Yes, I want all the material to be in one uniform codec, because the last thing you want is end users to be calling and having problems and confused and it's not matching up. So Apple ProRes really works best for me. It's pretty universal, and H.264 is as well. When I decide to visit a country, I open up Google Images on that country, and then I begin to look at the ones that impress me, and I find where those locations are. I do further research of just those locations, and I develop a Google map which has dots on it of all the places that I want to go and film. And that becomes my itinerary. Not hotels, not tourist attractions, each amazing local spot. I don't book anything in advance except the first night, because you don't know about the weather. And I find a good fixer, a professional in the country, who can help me, guide me through the country and make sure that everything goes smoothly. I have opinions of what I think are my best clips and what I think are my worst clips. And it often surprises me what sells. The market determines that. I have this little chime on my phone, and it goes off every time there's a sale. I get an email and it triggers a chime, and it's a ka-ching. It's like a cash register. I know, it's really awful. It's horribly materialistic, but you're in America now. So anyway, I don't mind hearing this ka-ching in the middle of the night. It can wake me up. I'm still happy. You know, it just tells me that somewhere out there somebody bought a clip, and those clips are the winners. I can't control it.